जय हिंद ऑल, माई सेल्फ अमिता अस्थाना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट, AKGEC गाज़ियाबाद। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म। सो वॉट इज फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म एंड वाई वी कैलकुलेट इट? एनी सिग्नल if it is in time domain, then it is naturally available, of course, and all the signals, they are available in time domain. But one thing we should remember, that all the signals which are available in time domain, that are better to be analyzed in frequency domain. That's a very important point which is to be considered for the signal to be analyzed in time domain to frequency domain, and we take the transformation from time domain to frequency domain. So here it is written, a real time naturally available signal, if it is available signal in the form of time domain, then it is far more convenient for us to analyze the given time domain signal into frequency domain. That's one important point. So basically there are three methods, or we can say three transformations, which are being used for analysis in frequency domain. These are, first, the Fourier transform, second is the Fourier series, and the third is Laplace transform. So basically these three methods are very important for any time signal we can convert into its frequency domain, and we can analyze or process the signal in their frequency domain. So we study about the Fourier transform basically in this lecture. Any signal, let's say any signal we can take, let's say it's a ft, any signal which is function of t, its Fourier transform can be written as a function of frequency, where omega is the frequency of the signal, frequency of the signal. Okay, so if a signal is given in time domain, its Fourier transformation can be written as f of j omega, right? So how to calculate the Fourier transform of any given signal, or how to convert a given signal in time domain to its frequency domain? So we have the formula for this, that f of j omega is nothing but the limits from minus infinity to plus infinity ft e into e ki power minus j omega t dt. So this is the basic formula by which we can calculate the Fourier transform of the given signal function ft. See the limits, it is from minus infinity to infinity, and any function can be converted into its frequency domain by this formula, especially when we talk of Fourier transform. So we will apply this formula to calculate the Fourier transform of few given signals. Let's say a very important signal which is frequently used to analyze the signal, or this rectangular signal for filter applications, we use this particular signal, and it's a very simple signal, that the signal ft is being given and its magnitude is 1 from the time limit minus t1 to plus t1. Okay, that means my ft is defined as 1 from minus t1 to plus t1. Otherwise, the value of the signal is 0. Okay, from minus t1 to plus t1, the magnitude of the signal is given as 1. Otherwise, the signal for the entire time domain except from minus t1 to plus t1, the signal takes the value to be 0. Okay. So, now we need to calculate the Fourier transform, and remember this is a very important function for the in terms of signal analysis or signals and system. This rectangular function is considered to be a very important function. So, let us calculate the Fourier transform for the given function. So, we will apply the same formula, that is f of j omega, that is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity f of t e raised to the power minus j omega t dt. Okay. Now, I will put the value of f of t as f of j omega. The limit is from minus infinity to infinity, but my value f t is taking as 1 from minus t1 to plus t1. So, I will put the limits for the integration from minus t1 to plus t1, and here it comes as 1 into minus j omega t dt. Okay. Now, I will take the integration, and this e raised to the power minus j omega t integration will be e raised to the power minus j omega t upon minus of j omega. So, here I will write the result minus j omega t upon minus j omega minus t1 to plus of t. Okay. Now, I will put my values to this function, that is e raised to the power minus j omega t upon minus j omega minus t1 to plus t1. I will put the limits and calculate the value for this. So, here I rewrite the given equation, that is f of e raised to the power minus j omega t upon minus j omega. Let me erase this. Okay. It will come to be e raised to the power of minus j omega t1 minus of e raised to the power plus of j omega t1 upon minus of j omega. Now, I am going to solve it as is equal to e raised to the power of j omega t1 minus e raised to the power of minus j omega t1 upon j omega. That I can write it as 2 j sine of omega t1 upon j omega. So, j to j cancel, and my f g omega comes out to be
omega t1 upon omega.
This is my Fourier transform of the given rectangular pulse. Now, a very important function in signals and system is known as sync function. What is sync function? It is frequently used function in this subject, and that is how we write it as very important function it is, and you need to remember this function all the time, that is sync function. And this is as sync of x is nothing but sine of pi x upon pi x. It is very important function in our frequency domain. So here we can say that this sync function, if I need to convert this fj omega in terms of sync function, so we have this function sync x. Now I convert my Fourier transform in this form. So here by few simple manipulation I can get it as sync omega t1 upon pi. Now this is my Fourier transform of this function, that is rectangular pulse, which is defined one from minus t1 to plus t1. Now next part, let us analyze this function okay. Now I have this 2 t1 sync of omega t1 upon pi. Now I want to draw this frequency transformation which already I have done in frequency domain. So what I will do, I will just make my axis, this is my omega axis and this is f of j omega function okay. For omega is equal to 0 at this point, for omega equal to 0, so I need to calculate this value, and by simple method I can get that if I tend this function for limit omega tending to 0. So what I will get, if I write it as, then my value will be of course 2 t1 for omega is equal to 0. And since it is a function which is a sinusoidal function, and I can see if my omega will get increased, if my omega is increasing, this function, because this omega is in denominator, then this function is decreasing. But there must be some oscillations. If it was only a sine function, then there were only oscillation and I could draw the simple sinusoidal function. But here, as this omega is in the denominator and it is increasing as on this axis, so this will be a decreasing kind of function. So magnitude of the entire fj omega will get decreased, but oscillations must be there, and as omega is tending to infinity, this value will get to 0 or it will approach towards 0. So what I can do is, this function will come like this. Similar way for minus omega. Now the frequency analysis of the rectangular pulse is being done. Now, if I want to find out what are these values at which this function is getting the zeros, what are these values? For this value, I can say whenever my omega t1 is equal to n pi for any sinusoidal function, that means whenever my omega t1 is equal to n pi, so this t1, that means, is equal to n pi by omega, all the values are 0. So it will be 0 at pi by omega, okay, at 2 pi by omega, at 3 pi by omega, and 4 pi by omega. Similar way, in the negative axis, this will be minus pi by omega value, minus 2 pi by omega, okay. So, that means I have analyzed the complete rectangular pulse in frequency domain. So, in this way, we can calculate the Fourier transform of any given time domain signal, and we can analyze the signal in terms of frequency domain. Now, coming to another example, let us say one function is given that is equal to e raised to the power minus a t into step function, which already we have discussed. This u t is equal to 1 for t is equal to and greater than 0, and u t is equal to 0 for t is less than 0. So, now here it is given that a is greater than 0, where a is the constant. Since it is a negative exponential function and this u t is defined only for the positive side of t, hence this function is exponentially decreasing as we can see in the graph, right. So, now the question says, what the question says, analyze the function in frequency domain. That means we need to take the Fourier transform again, and next is to calculate the bandwidth of the signal. Suppose a signal is being given and we need to calculate the bandwidth, then we must know the Fourier transform of this particular signal. In that case, we need to take the Fourier transform. That's it. So, now coming to calculation of the Fourier transform, again we will apply the same formula as we did earlier. F of j omega is equal to c minus infinity to plus infinity f of t is e raised to the power minus a t u t e raised to the power minus j omega t dt. That's correct. I have just applied the formula and this is my function e raised to the power minus a t into u t. Since my function is from 0 to infinity, so the limits will get changed and here I will get 0 to infinity e raised to the power minus a t u t will equal to 1 and e raised to the power minus j omega t dt. Okay. Now, we will solve the integration. And this will be e raised to the power of minus a plus j omega bracket t dt. And if I calculate, then I can get the integration value to be equal to minus of a plus j omega t upon minus of a plus j omega 0 to infinity. Okay, so I have f of j omega as e raised to the power minus a plus j omega e raised to the power minus a plus j omega t upon minus of a plus j omega. So it is, the limits are from 0 to infinity. 0 to infinity, we will put the limit value. So here it is, take this as a common, minus a plus j omega e raised to the power of minus a plus j omega into infinity minus e raised to the power minus of a plus j omega into 0. Now this will automatically, this term is getting to be 0 and this will be minus of e raised to the power 0. So I have this limit, that is 1 of a plus j omega. So my function f of j omega comes out to be 1 upon a plus j omega. So I have calculated till this point the Fourier transform of the given function, exponential function. Now I need to, but the question is saying that please calculate the bandwidth of the given signal. So I need to plot it again. I will plot the signal in frequency domain and then I will calculate the bandwidth, right? So plotting this, quickly we will erase this and f of j omega. So here this 1 upon a plus j omega, again I rewrite so that I can draw below this particular signal. Okay, this is the given function. I need to draw the frequency spectrum of this given function. Let us calculate the magnitude of fg omega. What is the magnitude? So the magnitude of the fg omega will be multiplied by the complex conjugate both in the numerator and the denominator. Just look at these steps, how I am doing this, 1 minus g omega upon, that will come out to be a square plus omega square magnitude. So here it will be, this magnitude term will and here it is under root of a square plus omega square, and in this way if I calculate, then it will be 1 upon under root of a square plus omega square. So the magnitude of fg omega will come like this. How we calculate the magnitude? I have just used the formula that if a function is being given a plus jb, then I can calculate a square plus b square, under root is the magnitude of the given complex number. Okay, so this formula I have used for calculating the magnitude and you can simply put it like this. Now let us assume for mod of f of j omega, this is my function. Now I need to draw the function. So here I make the graph. This is my omega axis and here it is my f of j omega. Okay. Let us calculate the value of this function at omega is equal to 0. For omega is equal to 0, if I calculate, this comes out to be 1 by a. Okay. Now this is my 1 by a. Now I will look for the decreasing trend for the omega. Now looking at the magnitude of fg omega, I can see very clearly that as omega is increasing, the function will look like that it is decreasing with increase of omega, like this. It will increase. Okay, and for omega tending to infinity, it should be 0. So it is tending towards 0. Similar pattern it will take for the minus values. Like this. But now this is my frequency transformation or frequency spectrum for the given function, and the given function was e raised to the power minus at into ut. But still I need to calculate the bandwidth of the signal. So what is the bandwidth? Let us calculate the bandwidth of the given signal. We are defining the bandwidth of the signal, the frequency at which the magnitude of the signal becomes root 2 of it. That means 1 upon root 2 into magnitude, that frequency is known as the bandwidth of the signal. That means by just find out the frequency at which the maximum amplitude of the signal is 1 by root 2 times of the magnitude. That means if I define in terms of formula, that means here if I want to calculate that omega for which the maximum amplitude becomes 1 by root 2 times of it, then we can get the bandwidth of the signal. So how we will calculate and how we will proceed, let us see. 1 upon under root of a square plus omega square. Let's say this omega is now omega 1, that frequency at which the signal magnitude becomes 1 by root 2 of 1 by a is my maximum amplitude, as we can see at omega is equal to 0. Now I need to find out this particular omega 1. So for finding out this omega 1, by simple formula, just square both sides. Okay, and after squaring, what we get as omega 1 is equal to plus minus a. That means there is a frequency omega 1 at which the amplitude of the signal becomes 1 by root 2 of a. Here also for the minus, because it is going to be a quadratic equation, so here also at this minus omega 1, the value of the signal is 1 by root 2 of the maximum amplitude of the given signal in terms of frequency analysis. So now we will define what is bandwidth. So my bandwidth here is minus a, w1 is plus a as I have calculated. So this has now become to be 2a. So Now I can say the bandwidth of the given signal is nothing but 2A. Okay, so we have calculated the bandwidth of the given signal. Also, we have drawn the spectrum of the given signal, and everything we have summarized from the Fourier transform of the given signal. And that is all for this lecture. Thank you.